Welcome to Dalfsen, the Netherlands. My name is Bob, and this is our little paradise where I live with my wife and my daughter. And I'm going to show you a little bit around how I've built this house out of recycled materials. And the special part of this show is that we built with living trees, which I call live tree architecture. These are on a Facebook group. I found someone who had a big load of 70s school tales from the kids, and I turned them into planters, as you can see. And the way I stack them provides me some open spaces here, and I fill them with earth. And in these open spaces, I plant these are elm trees, and they can grow for at least 15 years within the planter. And in that time, I'm going to connect them like. So here, and then I'm going to put a little nail through it, and then you get then I pleach them together that way, so they'll merge together and start sharing their sap stream. So in about 5 years, this whole wall will be one elm tree, and that's going to support the house eventually. So for now, I build a house out of planters, but in 10 to 15 years, the planters become, you know, they're still there, but they don't have any function anymore because the tree is actually carrying the house. Well, in these times, everybody's talking about CO2, of course. And this, instead of CO2 neutral building, this is O2 positive building. So the house will eventually, or from the start already, take in CO2 and provide oxygen, and it will clean the air. And you have a really thick wall. So it's an earthen wall, which provides a lot of insulation. And it will repair itself, because a tree, if I put a lot of weight on this branch, it will put more wood here, so it will strengthen itself on the place where it gets the most pressure. So instead of painting or redoing your house, you just have to maintain the trees. It's a different style of maintenance, but it's I think it's a future-proof way of building. So this tree I connected about a year and a half ago with a little screw in here and there and a couple more places, and you can see that it's growing together here. And it's now that if I would now take the bottom tree away, then this top part would still grow on because they've started sharing their sap stream. Well, for those of you out there who want to try it for yourself, there's a couple of things you need to be careful about. So the planters need to be big enough, because like this wall, I haven't had to water in 2 years and it's still growing good because I have big enough planters. So these are a meter wide, 50 centimeters deep and 50 high. And the material you use need to be at least 10 to 15 years structural sound. So you can use oak, thick oak, or acacia. I don't know how you call it in English, but I used the recycled stuff, and it's sort of like a fiber with resin. So it's not the most, it won't degrade this stuff, which is okay. But if I would like for my next house to use degradable materials, that so then when 10, 15 years, when the trees support the house, the planters get eaten by the tree. And then you have a house that is fully made of trees, roots and earth. So for the trees you use, first you look around at the place where you live, what kind of trees grow well there. So in this case, this is the west wall, which doesn't get a lot of sun. So that's why I use ash tree. It grows here, these are all from the forest. And on the other side I have elm. But on the south wall I'm planning to use fruit trees. And then I collect fruit trees from the same family, so they merge together. And then there's an American guy who's growing the tree of 40 fruits. And he uses the stone fruits, because there's 40 different fruits you can bleach together. So you can design your wall, the color in the spring from the blossom, which gives a whole new vibe to your house, of course. And it's edible. Yeah, this building I built out of tree branches, which I found a little bit further by the railroad. They were cutting trees there and they left these branches lying around. And then, so I built the structure out of these branches. This is actually a carrying structure. And then I filled it out with wood fiber board, which I got for free on the internet. And then the top part, I wanted to do it with loam, but it's Dutch weather and it's not really great for using loam outside, because you get fungus in it and everything. So this is a finish based on cement, and that keeps the interior dry. So this whole building I built for about €1,000, including all the installations inside. Yeah, this is our bathroom with this is the compost toilet, sort of a compost throne. And we use the compost in our garden, not the vegetable garden, but the rest of the garden. And here we have our shower cave. And we heat the water by, there's a ex-gas boiler here, which I turned into a wood boiler. So I have to burn wood in the bottom part there. And then I heat up about 140 liters of water. And then we can shower for about 45 minutes. Well, we bought this house about 10 years ago. And the roof was leaking and there were like four small rooms in here. So I took out the whole interior and rebuilt it, and I put a new roof on top. And everything you see here is also, again, recycled material. Like this part of the kitchen over here, the wood was used for building huts nearby, like a weekend with the kids building huts. And then afterwards I could pick up the wood and build a kitchen out of it. Here we have a filter system, because we use either water from the ground or rainwater. And then we have a pre-filter. And then over there we have our final filter, which turns it into drinking water. And it works. We have water. And this all works on two solar panels. So we use a very little power, just for the pump, telephone and the laptop. And the lights, of course. And then in the summer we use the fridge, which works in the summer if we have enough sun. And in the winter it's cold enough outside, so we just store our cold goods outside. And then over here is a really nice, I also got this from my garden. This is a curly willow, and I made the branches so they all interconnect. And this is this is how I like to build, with stuff from the garden and stuff that I get for free or for very little money. Well, this is going to be my daughter's room, and she wanted a three sleeper, like three stages of bed. And this is my style of building, so she didn't know I was going to build this, but she's really happy with it. And she's already playing with her girlfriends here. And and it's all like the branches I got from my own garden, from trees that needed trimming. And the rest is all recycled. Like these walls are built from waste wood from the wood supplier, and they normally throw it away or even have to pay to get rid of it. So I get it for free. And then there's some friends who put some nice carvings in there, which is really nice. And this is sort of my style, how I like to build. I spent about 4 months in Australia in nature under a tarp, and that's where I found my connection with nature. And when I then came back to Holland, I saw that nature here is more of a thing that, you know, we have forests but not really big ones, and nature for people is to relax, but it has no other function in Holland. So I thought, if I want to bring back forests in Holland, I'd have to find a way to make it that people understand that it's not just a tree to enjoy, but it has a lot of functions. So this is my way of showing how we can integrate nature with our lives, because people and nature have become quite separate from each other. So I believe that if we start growing our houses and living inside living trees, that automatically our connection with nature will be restored. Maybe it takes a couple of generations, but you have to start somewhere.
Thank you for watching. Hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. Questions or remarks, post them in the comments down below. If you like our video, just click the subscribe button so you never miss an episode. Thank you for watching.